It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, your company wants to deploy several microservices to help your system handle elastic loads. Each microservice uses a different version of software libraries. You want to enable the developers to keep their development environment in sync with the various production services. Which technology should you choose? So in this project scenario, we've got several microservices being developed by different teams. And possibly each of them have different development environments. When these are being deployed in production, we want to ensure that the production environment matches the development environment, and therefore there won't be any problems in that deployment. We now need to choose the right technology to get this result. Let's first look at option D, which suggests virtual machines. Now, this is such a vague answer. Everything is eventually going to run on a virtual machine. So there is no differentiator in this option. And for me, therefore, option D is a straight elimination. One tip in the approach that I would give you is that you can first remove the obviously wrong options. Just reducing the number of options that you have to work with will improve your chances of getting it right. So in this case, virtual machines being an obvious requirement for any kind of deployment is not going to have a special differentiation compared to the other options. So option D is out. How about RPM or DEB? These are package formats for the Red Hat or Debian distributions to install applications. Immediately, the question you should ask is, are these the only formats possible? Could there be another kind of distribution package? My answer is yes, there could be. So if the developer was using some other type of package or they intend to use something in the future, just using RPM or DEB is not going to work for us. Moreover, it does not also solve the problem of keeping the development environment in sync with the various production environments. It is possible that the developer has used different versions of these packages, and the ops team has to constantly be on top of what the development team is using to mimic that environment in production. So using RPM or DEB does not suit a requirement that we keep the dev environment and the prod environment in sync. Therefore, option A is out. How about Chef or Puppet? Chef and Puppet are used for configuration management of VMs. This has the same problem as you would have with the RPM and dev option. A developer could have used one version of the package, of the same package, say via RPM or DEB, and another developer could have used a different version of the package. Chef and Puppet allows you to install these machines and quickly put an environment on these VMs. But this still requires us to know what that environment is. And therefore, if the developer has a slightly different environment, the ops team in production has to know what has changed and include that as part of the Chef code or the Puppet configuration. Given that, option C to use Chef or Puppet still does not suit a requirement to keep the development environment in sync with the production services. The one we are left with is containers. When people use containers, they are able to package the app along with the development environment into a container image, which can be directly deployed by the ops team. So in the case of container applications or containerized applications, you will have app A along with the environment that it was potentially developed in. Whereas in the case of a virtual machine, you're going to have the operating system, which is on a virtual machine of some type. And within that, you would probably use Chef or Puppet to create the virtual machine. But the application itself is going to be dependent on the VM. And different versions of the applications now will either have to be put on different virtual machines, which increases the resource usage because each of them have the guest operating system repeated. So even though it's possible to do this, it's way more resource hungry and therefore not the best option. Containerized applications, on the other hand, suit this requirement very well. The developer has control over what is packaged, and exactly that can be deployed on to production. Therefore, option B is the best answer of the lot that we have for this question. All right, now it's time for you to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead, do that right now, because there's loads of great content coming up for learning Google Cloud and preparing for the certifications.